Hello, my name is Keshwani.
That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I,
Keshwani. We are here because we want to prepare for the GRE. We have been solving GRE math problems out of this book here, The Official Guide to the Revised GRE, the second edition. If you do not own this book already, purchase one immediately. You're going to need it. Today, we'll solve a problem which you will find on page number 272. It's important that you have the book in front of you, otherwise you will not be able to follow it. Page number 272, turn to it. Example 4.2.5. In that example, we are given some observations. Let's see how many there are. We are given 16 observations. We're going to list them on the blackboard and we'll see what we can do with them.
We have 2, 4, 4, 5. 2, 4, 4, 5. Then we have 7, 7, 7, 1, 2, 3, 6 sevens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 sevens. 2 eights, 2 eights, and 4 nines. There we go. These are the 16 observations that are given to us, and we are asked to figure out different quartiles. First quartile. What does quartile mean? First quartile. Quartile means 25% of the observation. The first quartile means the bottom 25% of observations. Since we only have 16 observations, one quarter of 16 is 4, so the bottom 25% of the observation is basically 4 observations. So you just count 1, 2, 3, 4. There you go. That's the fourth observation. That's the fifth observation. Right here is the first quartile, Q1. And since they are different numbers, we have to take the average of the two, 5 plus 7 over 2, and the first quartile is simply 6. Second quartile, we count 4 more, 1, 2, 3, 4. Right here is the second quartile. So I'm going to erase all of this thing now. We're just going to put down 6. First quartile is the average of the fifth observation. Average of the fourth observation and the fifth observation, if they are different. Next quartile, another 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, right here. So second quartile is right here, which is simply 7. We go 4 more, we find the third quartile. 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, this is the 12th observation, this is the 13th observation. The middle is this one, that's your third quartile, which is going to be 8.5. The question is, what do these figures tell us? Think of this in terms of score, if it makes it easier. If it makes it easier for you, think of these in terms of score. A teacher gave a quiz which was based on 10 questions. So you get 10 points if you got all 10 of them, all 10 questions right. And the 16 students in the class, their scores are listed as such. 1, 2, 3, 4 people got 9 out of 10, one person got 2 out of 10, and so on and so forth. What does this figure tell you? 8.5. The third quartile tells you, that if you had a score of 8.5, 75% of the people, 75% of the people scored below you. This is same as, this third quartile is same as the top 25th percentile. So if you scored 8.5 or above, you are in the top 25th percentile in the class. You are in the top 1/4 of the class. 3/4 of the class scored below you. Similarly, if you happen to score 6 points, that means first quartile means 25% of the people, 25% of the people, or the students scored below you. 25% of people scored below you, 25th percentile. This is the 25th percentile, 25th percentile. And what do you suppose this represents? This represents the 50th percentile. 50th percentile. Well, 50th percentile has a name. The point at which half the scores are below it and half the scores are above it, we have a name for it. We call it median. So 2nd quartile, which represents the 50th percentile, but that's your median. Median in this case is 7. So if you have a score of 7, half the people scored below you, half the people scored above you. Well, not quite in this sense, because all of these people are also 7, but you get the idea. That's your median. So we have our first quartile, which is the 25th percentile.
which is 6 in this case.
First quartile is 6.
We have our second quartile, which is this one right here, which is 50th percentile, which is the median.
And you would write this as 50th percentile is written as this. 50, P with 4 percentile, with a subscript for 50. This one would be written as P subscript 25,
25th percentile.
And similarly, this one would be written as P subscript 75.
This is 75th percentile. And median, of course, is 7. What's the mode here?
Well, mode is the most frequently appearing observation. Here we have a whole bunch of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's the one that occurs most often. So mode in this case is 7.
Mode is 7. What is the range?
What is the range of this observation? Range is from the greatest to the lowest. The greatest minus the lowest, in this case, is 9 minus 2. The range of this observation is
7. The range of this observation is 7. Let's talk about something called interquartile range. Interquartile range. These are very simple concept. Not too many people have trouble with this thing. Let's talk about interquartile range.
Remember, this was the first quartile, this was the 1, 2, 3, 4, this was the second quartile. I don't know why this is here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, that was, I don't know why this, it should have been there. 1, 2, 3, 4, right here, 8.5. That's your third quartile, which was 8.5. I don't remember what the check mark, point was there for. That's your
third quartile. Interquartile range.
Interquartile range is from here to right here. From 6 to 8.5. And this is called interquartile range. Interquartile range is the range of the middle 50% of the population of the observations.
Middle 50% of the observations. In other words, if you're talking about interquartile range, the beginning point is the first, is the end of the first quartile, and beginning of the fourth quartile. Interquartile range tells you the points between which 50% of the observation fell. 25% of the observations are going to be below it, 25% of the observations are going to be above it.
And the middle 50%, the middle 50%, right here, range of the middle 50%, middle 50% is your interquartile range. It's usually written like this, interquartile range, which is simply the range of the beginning of the fourth quartile, which is right here, end of the third quartile, minus the end of the first quartile. In this case, it is 8.5 minus 6, it is 2.5. 8.5. Minus 6,
which is 2.5 in this case. The last thing we're going to talk about is what is known as a box and whisker plot.
Box and whisker plot. Let's talk about it. We're going to
box and whisker plot goes something like this.
Box and whisker plot. You're done with all of this thing?
To draw a box and whisker plot, you have to know what is the starting point, what's the end point here.
It begins with 2, ends at 9, so we can start with 1, or if you like, from 0, if you like. That doesn't really matter, let's start with 0, all the way up to 10. The reason we start with 0 is because then it's easier to cut everything off. So here, right in the middle somewhere here, it's going to be our 5, so we have to cut this into 5 equal parts. Here we go, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. There you go. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. 6, 7, 8 and 9. 6, 7, 8 and 9 and 10. There we go.
Interquartile range. Oh, this is called
box and whisker plot. Box and whisker plot.
What does a box and whisker plot tell you? It shows you a lot of things. It shows you a lot of things. This is how it goes. First, we have to locate the lowest observation. The lowest observation in this case is 2. So that's where it begins. The story begins at the lowest thing, right here. And then you put down L here. You don't have to put L here because people understand that this line indicates the lowest point in the observations. And then we look at the highest point. Highest here is 9. So it's going to be here. That's the N. Again, you don't have to put down G. It's understood. The end of the Whisker class is the highest observed value, the highest observation. Let's put this, and then draw a line like this. And we have to locate all the quartile. Our first quartile was at 6. If you remember, it was the 6. 6 is right here. Right here is the first quartile. Our second quartile was 7. It's right here. Our third quartile was 8.5, right here, 8.5, right here, 8.5, it's right here, bring it down. Now we have enough information here to plot our box and whisker plot. Box and whisker plot shows us the interquartile range, the range of the middle 50% of the population. So it begins here, this is the middle 50%. From 6, we talked about it, the range is 2.5, from 6 to 8.5, right here. From range is 6 to 8.5, right here, and this part right here, which is the 50th percentile, we talked about it right here, the second quartile. This is the first one, 1, 2, 3, 4. This was 6, 7 right here, and we darken this part as well. So this is your first quartile. This is the third quartile. This right here, the darkened line, is actually the 50th percentile, the median. The median, which is same as the 50th percentile, which is same as the second quartile. You can call it second quartile, you could call it median, or you can call it the 50th percentile. They all mean the same thing. 50th percentile means 50% of the observations are above it, 50% of the observations are below it, which is the definition of second quartile, which is also the observation, obviously, the median. What else? Did we leave anything out here? So in this case, if you look at it, we can see that the middle 50% of the observation fell between 6 and 8.5. The lowest observation was 2. The highest observation was 9. Even if we did not have this L and G written here, it's understood. This is the end point of the big box and whisker. This is the beginning point of the box and whisker. That tells us that this represents the lowest observation. This represents the highest observation. This is the median. This is the end of the first quartile, beginning of the second quartile. This is the end of the third quartile, beginning of the fourth quartile. This is the interquartile range. The box that you see there, it encloses interquartile range. That was it. See you tomorrow, okay? Bye now.